play Minecraft to cook some raw fish because they smell really nasty. Kill some mods before you get on their plates so you don't get to feel the pain. And then you craft and mine and dig it to gain experience points, yeah. And then just try to get raw pork from pigs. Has no end, but it's still the best game. It's the eye of the spider, it's poison in one bite. Oh, look out, I'm an excellent fighter. The creepers and zombies, other mobs of the night. Spiders give you some string in the eye of a spider. Never eat the rotten flesh. It makes you starve in the night. Tame a wolf and train it to play fetch. They don't need if you want to survive. It's the eye of the spider, it's poison in one bite. Oh, look out, I'm an excellent fighter. The creepers and the zombies, other mobs of the night. Spiders give you some string in the eye of the spider. Don't fall in to the void, it's so odd. When it comes to your days, they're the last ones. Is your failure no evil game on? Just the villain of the great York's cast. The eye of the spider is poison in one bite. Oh, look out, I'm an excellent fighter. The creepers and the zombies, other mobs of the night. Spiders give you some string in the eye of the spider. Spider. The eye of the spider. The eye of the spider.
Hello! Whoa, 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 whoa. Hello! Hey, it's me. I'm excited. I'm ready to begin. Hey, Mr. Smeeb! Listen, don't worry. I'm not dying, Mr. Smeeb. Thank you for that 7 months. I'm only gonna be gone for a little bit. This is my last stream. I'm heading abroad, and, I'll be back in 2 weeks, so it's not a big deal, don't worry, especially don't unsubscribe. That would be a horrible decision on your part. It would be just a terrible decision that would leave your life in ruins.
Hey, make sure hey. Sense, my meal. Good job,
it's not
man.
Goodbye, get son. It's see you later. We gotta play that Paul Walker song. You guys see Ludacris's CGI abs? I can't figure out if it was meant to be a joke or not. I guess they are supposed to be a joke. You guys seen them? You guys seen Ludacris' CGI abs? Sorry, this is,
Get the showers. Oh, fuck.
Hey, little dark one! Thank you for that resub. That 27-month resub!
Hey, Snake, they're fake.
Oh shit, I'm sorry.
Good job, man. Hit the showers.
Hey, Magic Miss Olympic.
Yourself, man.
Thank you for that half a year. Ignore the lewd imagery. Hold on, let me size this up. Let me size this up for you so you can see him.
I mean, there's a lot of women out here that's just,
they look,
you know,
so cool.
They just deficient in so many things.
He's missing a fucking nipple. So many things, man. It's really cool. So many key nutrients in your life. I like that. All right. Yeah, they sample the thong song in that. Well, they do more than sample it. It's pretty much that. Let's make today good. It's my final stream. I've been preparing and packing, doing the final stuff for my trip.
Hey,
but now's the time to dedicate to you.
Good job,
hey,
man.
Hey, Quack, thank you for that 15
Go
months.
Fuck yourself, man.
Many blessings. Man, the thing is about me leaving, I'm very excited for this trip. I've been planning this trip for a long time. But I feel so uncomfortable not streaming for that long. Like, believe it or not, fucking streaming has become just like, I can't go too long without doing it. Like, I'm too deep in this where, like, it almost feels like necessary for my sanity to stream. I've just done this for so long that now I have to keep doing it. That's not to say I don't enjoy it. That's my point is that I enjoy it. Hey, shut up and slam. Thank you for that 13 months. Oh, except every other day. Listen, to say I don't stream every other day is a massive exaggeration. I miss at most 2 days a week. I miss on average 2.5 days a week. All right, let's get straight. All right, but I'm doing a lot of stuff in Japan. I'm gonna try and find a place. I've been looking. I found a potential place, but I emailed them. They didn't email me back. Presumably, because they don't understand what I'm saying. But I don't have the data right to IRL stream. I don't have the infrastructure there. But hey, it is what it is. I feel like I've started the stream off completely with a complete lack of eloquence. I can't speak today, but whatever. Let's fucking do it. Oh. I ain't got the anti-malox money. Dude, fucking Ice Poseidon has, like, a satellite, and, like, he's got a DSLR attached to this fucking satellite. I don't even know what that kind of technology is. And he uses it to fucking just be super awkward around women. It's truly the fucking pinnacle of technology. But, alas... Let's do it. Woo woo! You can stream from a DSLR over Wi-Fi? Impossible, my friend. Impossible. What airline am I using? The best one. And I'm gonna leave it at that. I'm hoping to get knocked the fuck out on my flight. That'd be fucking sick. Take that settlement, and then they dig up shit from my past to make me look bad and try and redeem the airline. That's what they're doing to that guy now. They're like digging up shit from his past to like try and rationalize them beating the shit out of him. You see, they knocked him out because he traded drugs for sex 20 years ago. Hey, Mr. Cottonballs. Hey, bless both of you. I will have a good time. Let's do this shit, though. I found a game. It's a new game, a new release for my favorite sport of all time. I've never shared how much I enjoy said sport, but I keep a lot of things a secret just so I can say these things whenever I do anything in life. How would I feel about Esteban being used against you as exhibits in a court of law? That'd be truly bizarre. That would be something else. Back in the day, like, all the fucking Second Life weirdos that thought I was, like, breaking laws by talking to them. I'm sure they could see that as a feasible thing. Alright, let me show you this. Yes! Yes! Everything is fucking rocks out these days, dude. This is definitely real sport, like 100%, right? Well, yeah. I don't want to get into what a sport... Wait, is this made by Zordon? Zordon? What is Zordix. What is Zordix made? Ooh, they made an Aqua Racing game? Oh, that one of my friends owns? Oh, it's Barney, dude. Barney owns this game. He's familiar with Zordix. Zordon's dick. Yep, that's exactly what it is. It's a nice portmanteau. Oh, let's begin the experience. Yes! I'm stoked, my man. I forgot what this game's called. It's definitely not on Twitch's games list. Oh, it is. Wait, kinda. Oh yeah, it is. Alright, let's update this. Let me tell you something, I'm about to rock the fuck out. Yeah, you gotta shred some powder. You gotta carve, as they say. Where's my fucking controller? Get out! Ugh. Let's do this shit, baby! Oh, Dave of Sweden. I don't know why they're assuming I'm Swedish. I assume they're the main demographic for this players are Swedish youths. But regardless, let's pick something good. I like the cool runnings, like 2017 plotline we could make here. Jamaica. Oh, now this is what I'm talking about. This is the level of customization that I really strive for. Alright. Everybody knows that the best color combination in the game is hot pink, brown, and teal. Edit name. Bint Snow Race. Straight to online multiplayer. Excuse me, where are the games? I'm Bint Snow Race. Let's go. Somebody join my game. Excuse me.
Hey, snakes are set, Squire Bill. Good job, man.
Hey, no problem, Prawns. I'm glad someone recognizes the risk I take every time I do this. Let's go. Sprint League, baby! Alright, I'm gonna take the Mizumoto Fury 290. It's a 600cc vehicle. You know, this one's the best thing about it is the steering, the second being acceleration, the third being turbo, the fourth being top speed, and the fifth being grip. I have a non-stop flight. There. And on the way back, I stop in fucking Beijing. I gets down in Beijing. Oh my god, here we go. Does this thing have NOS? Is that what I'm feeling when I press A? No. Oh, I'm behind Kazmir Golubkin. These guys think you gotta take a special route to get through. You gotta go straight through the obstacles. You see, the key to this, and I can already tell this isn't a bad game, and I just... The key to this game is to give no fucks, my boy. That looked good as fuck. My man's, doesn't handle snow too well, as you can see. Sunk straight into the goddamn ground. There is NOS! Now anyone, that knows about these things, do snowmobiles typically come equipped with NOS? I'm going through the mountains. This is the best thing you can do in this situation. Third, not so bad. Yes! Okay. God, Nina Krieger. Typical. They always said Kriegers can't drive, my guy. Let's retry this. I'm getting number one. This game is actually, I can already tell, it's not bad. It's not humorously bad. This is just a failure altogether. I only play games so that I can scrutinize them. In this game, you know, not that bad. Give it a 10 out of 10. Yeah, it's like a 12-hour flight. My ass. You know, all the thing is about this game, all these guys could grab a beer with Huan Chang, Kazimir, Golubkin, Hannah Vogel. They're all just a bunch of friendly snowmobile riders, and I think that's what we're meant to take away from this game. Doesn't matter where you're from, your sex or orientation, you're welcome in the world of snowmobile racing. And I fucked that up somehow. And Bent Snow Race is in last place. I'm gonna give this one more shot. Hey, thank you, little dark one. Many blessings. Do you guys also feel that in some strange way, Bent Snow Race kind of fits in with the other names? Strange to say, but I feel like it's true. I've been to a maid cafe before. I told you guys when I went and they gave us like some bucktooth German woman because she spoke English. That's mean. It's just the situation. It's just an accurate depiction of the situation. This game's main character, Bent Snow Race, is actually really likable. Oh, yes! And he takes the lead! And he's fucking it up completely! And he fucks it up completely somehow! With ease, he throws the race for no reason. She wasn't kawaii? Listen, I don't want to be a racial, but when you go to a maid cafe in Tokyo, you expect a Japanese maid. I didn't go to a maid cafe expecting some American woman named Nancy to serve me flapjacks. I didn't come to Tokyo for that experience. Oh god. Oh god. I guess that's possible. Oh, those people were really back there. And they're butler cafes? Dude, that'd be fucking sick. I want a dude who looks like Jeffrey from The Fresh Prince. He was the worst butler of all time. He talked so much shit. Who wants a shit-talking butler who just hates you? Check out the Jumpy's Cafe. What if there was just a strange phenomenon where Japan really got into Jumpy's Jump? Fuck this up. No, I'm good. Yes! Fuck yeah! Charlie, my sis thinks everyone who smoke pot is a pothead. What do I do to change her mind? Well, what you want to do is force feed her an edible. Don't do that. That's not a good idea, but let's go ahead and quick join an online multiplayer game. All right, I'm preparing. Listen, I'm very confident that someone is online and ready to play the Alps with Dave 2013. Alright, here we go. This is what I was looking for. Oh shit, there's fucking jumps? Alright, let me try that again. And just like that, I nailed it. And just like that, I showed you on the one. Man, I told you, I'm a legend in these streets, in these snows. Alright, front flip. That'll seal the deal. The judges will love this. Oh, that was sick. Alright. Hope for the best, but prepare for the worst. Let's do this. I love that little bounce upwards every time. Oh, that's not the button. Let me do 360. There's got to be a move to do like tricks and stuff. Yeah! Wait, what happens if I land like that? Hypothetically, I would smash my testicles. Let's try it again. Oh, that's not the one. I like how it warns you too. Sit back! Oh, man. Come on, baby. Give it to me. This is just a comical string of events. That leaves me breathless. If you get any street fights in Japan, make sure you're carrying a Pepsi to hand the samurai. Pepsi solves everything, right? So I'm gonna do that. That was almost it, though. Alright, no hands backflip. Or whatever move comes out. Now that's a move right there, my man. We got that first person view. Alright, I'm gonna show you guys what it feels like to be me. To be a legend in the game. I'm running out of time, but I can do it. This is what it's like to get sick air. Impressed? I bet you are. I bet you are, my man. I don't blame you. That's just the way it be. Alright, what do I do? That turned out to be incredible. Where do I take it from there? Okay, so wait, what the? Oh, never mind.
Donation.
Hey, great, thank you. Donation. That's gonna buy me a whole mini bottle of vodka.
No art. Donation.
Wow, I sure deserve all this money.
It's gonna buy me like three bowls of ramen. Buy yourself some airplane food with this. Three bowls of ramen. Should we check Kickstarter? Should we open up Yakuza? What can we do? What do we do? What do we do? All right. Hey, thank you. My refund or nah videos are my famous contribution to the gaming culture. Gaming culture is what keeps me going. Don't worry. I haven't looked at Kickstarter in a while. And, you know, I want the Kickstarter community to know that I am watching. Even when it looks like I am in another country, I'm actually not. I'm just browsing Kickstarter in silence, waiting to strike.
games, the greatest sinners of all, how come... God, my top donation thing, I swear to God. It drives me off the wall. There we go. Alright. Games! Oh, I fucking love video games! You see, the thing about Kickstarter is that everybody deserves $500,000. That's what I've learned. People don't understand that every person ever who has an idea needs $500,000 to make it happen. Alright. So, these are ending soon. These both of these have been... Whoa, that's actually a lot of money for a visual novel game. Beautiful. Safe zone. These snowflakes and their safe spaces, you know, right, guys? And they even made a board game. They couldn't handle normal board games. Anyways, let's... Amazing Scriptures, Book 1, The Missing Map. Oh, a book of mazes and comics based on stories from the Book of Mormon. Oh!
Hi, I'm Norman Trilliff, and I'm excited to introduce you.
His name's Norman the Mormon, my man. Norm the Morm. I love this guy already. It's fucking Norman the Mormon in the building.
To my latest project, The Amazing Scriptures, Book 1, The Missing Map. The Amazing Scriptures combines mazes and comics with stories from the Book of Mormon. In a regular maze book, each page is one maze from start to finish. But The Amazing Scriptures, Book 1, The Missing Map is one...
That actually is a cool looking maze. For the wreck. Joseph Smith would be proud. He'd be like, these mazes put my own golden tablets to shame. Didn't he have golden tablets, Joseph Smith? Didn't he like write some shit down, some golden tablets?
That is 12 pages long. The maze plays a lot like The Legend of Zelda, where you search around for keys.
Donation alert. Donation.
Liquid Gaga, thank you.
Donation alert. Donation alert. Donation.
Wow, I sure deserve all this money.
Have fun in Japan. Here's some noodle money.
Thank you. I appreciate the noodle money. I'm gonna be consuming them noodles like no one else.
Enter new areas of the maze. In a regular maze, when you reach a dead end, you simply turn around or start the maze over. But in The Amazing Scriptures, when you reach a dead end, you roll a dice to find out what happens. Reaching a dead end can even alter the story.
It's kind of cool for a maze book. I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm not a Mormon, but nice mazes, bro. You see, it feels like you could get this funded pretty quickly if you advertised it in the right places. You know what I mean? If you marketed this in like to some actual Mormons, I feel like they could get behind this idea. You know what I'm saying?
As you play through the maze, you'll
he didn't write those. It was given him to
read events
to him by
in
the
this
angel
way, the
named
comic
Macaroni.
Story unfolds as you journey through the maze.
I want to meet an
Thank
angel
you so much
named
for checking out
Macaroni.
The Amazing Scriptures, Book 1, The Missing Map.
Man, I wish if I was a Mormon, I'd help this guy out, but I'm not. I'm just an agnostic, cynical creep boy. And did I say I'm agnostic? I'm a devout Christian. Sorry, I forgot about my thing. I didn't expect to shit on that. But, Mormons are super racist, though. They hate homosexuals, too. But you can't be surprised when any religious person hates any group. Because it's just the way it is. You know what I mean?
It's like Catholics, the fucking priests be fucking little boys. I have no more surprise left in my body for any act done in the name of religion.
Donation.
It's exactly where that'll go.
Donation alert.
Wow, I sure deserve all this money.
Get yourself some used panties at your local Kobini store with this.
Hey, thank you so much, Mr. Smeeb. It's very generous. I appreciate that. Thank you. Oh shit, I'm skipping over stuff. I'm feeling such elation. The country. I really want my game to be like GTA. I'm 12 years old. My ambition in life is to become a game developer. Listen, you're 12. You don't need money. Like, when I was 12, I was writing, like, really shitty, stories, right? And, like, people around me were like, oh my god, you're such a good little writer. If people gave me fucking money for the shit I was doing, like, the idea of giving money to someone that young to make a project is just so funny to me. Pounds, so that's even fucking more. Well, yeah, don't give a 12-year-old money. They don't know what the fuck they're doing. Let's go. This is what he has to show? He doesn't even have anything! It's gonna be similar to GTA. You have a fucking barn? You have a brick home with a protruding wall? Fuck! Why does he have... Don't give people money. Are we giving him money on the basis that he's fucking 12 and he made a brick shed? This is just teaching kids the wrong lesson. Will you actually sell this game for money? No, I will not sell the game for money. What is this for? Are you actually 12 years old? Yes. Yes, I am. The cadence of an old man. Yes. Yes, I am. Why do you want to be a game developer? I think I could be a successful game developer because I already know how to code and I'm only 12. Let's see you put your coding skills to the test. I like your big plane with your shed. Risks and challenges. My risks are that my game won't make it onto Steam and that people won't fund my Kickstarter to get this game finished. So this will be a really hard challenge to do. Wait, why do you need money? I'm needing $80 or above to put my game on. You don't have a game! Duh! Duh! And he's like, he's... Wait, 20 people pledged for his Skype? I don't want to make the joke here, but, you know, mostly grown people are supporting Kickstarters. I wonder what type of grown person would want this 12-year-old Skype. Oh, Lord. I wonder what category of criminal. This is blowing my mind, dude. This is one of the worst. This is bad, man. A shout out on YouTube. It's by Dagon. Hi, Dagon. Oh my god. I have a good head on my shoulders. Know what I want to achieve. I realize that in life you have to push yourself if you want to make it in this world, and I'm 110% committed. You're fucking 12! You're 12! Let's go to this other one. It's the same shed! It was a month ago, he hasn't built on this. Oh, dude, he started milking the 12 years old thing. Oh my god. He put the 12 year old thing. Oh my god. He just re-uploaded it. The only difference between the two is that he put his 12-year-old in his fucking main description. He could just be a scammer. But, I don't know. There's just no explanation for, like, what the game is. It's clearly not a game. Alright, whatever. It's fine. I'm just gonna move on from that. Fuck that kid. Whoa, it has 10 comments? Let's see. They better. Oh, God. Oh, no. Yeah, I'm first and probably last. You asked for help, and here it is. I'm not talking about the money, because you would need additional supports to get it. Oh. I pledged for more dubious projects than this one. Looking at you, Dust of Babylon. God, they're all like trying to fucking inspire this kid. But the thing is, you know, we shouldn't teach people that they need money to pursue projects like this. He doesn't have a game and he's already thinking about publishing it on Steam? Why? Why do you need to do that? Like, why don't you just hone your skills? This is the thing that frustrates me the most about Kickstarter. It's like you're coming with some half-baked shit because you're so clearly thinking about money before the work you're doing. And this kid is just like a juvenile illustration of that practice. And his dad, allegedly, is the one pushing that. What does a 12-year-old need fucking money for? Oh, Lord. Oh. Hey! You must be a genius to solve these cubes. Fuck you, Dagon. I hope you never graduate middle school. He's a fake son. It could be. Ninja bounce. Watch a ninja cut your child's birthday cake with a samurai sword. I'm into it. You better have a fucking video. Damn it! Hello, all. I just turned 40 years old. He's talking about autism. I'm just scanning this, seeing if it's worth it. He's mentioning autism again. Does he just want to cut the cakes of autistic kids? I'm trying to grasp this from scanning it. This doesn't seem very thought out. Bring in your autistic child. We'll have a ninja cut his cake. Oh, Lord! Alright, The Cute, The Creepy, and The Clueless, the game. It has it's another Cards Against Humanity looking game, with 51 bucks with 38 hours to go. So let's check it out. $80,000. Let's see if it's worth it.
I am Mr. Rudy, a revolutionary, a visionary, and a baby. I am the leader of Rash, the revolution against adults pissing away our soon-to-be-inherited cash. R-A-A-O. Okay, so the acronym doesn't work, but what do you expect? I'm a baby, for crap's sake. Anyway, we convened a closed crib meeting yesterday to determine a course of action that may very well save all of humanity. We are deeply concerned about the consumerism that is rampant.
I don't like this either. I gotta be honest with you. The whole baby talking thing just fucking... It blows my mind. Like, I saw that Alec Baldwin trailer for the baby movie, and it just disgusted me so much. It's like, why is that funny? I thought we got over that when fucking John Travolta was a baby. That was a thing, right? Who's talking now?
The purchase of non-physical items like apps, internet and gaming software, and services such as car sharing and others, today's adults are frittering away the resources that our age-challenged peers would normally depend on in the future. This needs
What the fuck are you talking about?
I agree. Me too. I'm with you guys. We have crafted a plan together with our allies.
I'm beginning to see why this says $51. This is fucking weird.
And the clueless. To recapture these resources and ration them out over our own lifetimes. The creepy have agreed to use their fear-mongering to scare and distract those foolish adults. While the clueless...
It's like unsettling and like indecipherable.
...suspected of being our spies, as most look like they can't even tie their shoes. Finally, as babies, we have the power to get close to adults.
4 minutes of lame hell. Imagine you got to hell and it was just really fucking lame and like unimpressive.
Well, they will be quite surprised when
the devil's really insecure about it and shit. Okay.
Laying out the game tiles face down randomly. Each player gets 3 game pieces to move, and as they move, the tiles are revealed and can be things like the babysitter, security guards, alarms, guard dogs.
This is like the unbearable part of every one of these videos, when they explain the card game. Especially when I'm not interested in tabletop games. It might be for someone else. Who knows? I like an occasional child's game, no video. I like the most patronizing children's games. There's so many of them on here. It's a lot of fun. What about, what was the math bracelets? I actually got one of those, and I've learned math. 11 animals. Demuestra tu habilidad. Habilidad! Be quick, man! Alright, so the pitch so far, we'll see how it evolves, but right now it's just 11 animals. It's just a couple funny animals. It's just a paneled picture of animals. Thank you for your help. What? What did you do? Why am I helping you? Be quick, man. I wasn't expecting what I was gonna hear there. Wait, we've got 2 of the 11 animals so far. We're on our way. I don't know why that was so funny to me when that music started. Not my president! Which one of your friends is a Trump supporter? Who fucking cares?
I bet you're asking yourself, what is this? Let me start off. I love games. I do. I do. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Nobody loves games more than me. And when it comes to games...
Oh, is this supposed to be a Trump impression? I just caught on to it.
I love them. I do. I've made plenty of games. I've provided more games to the American people than Obama ever will, ever has been, will go, games. And this one, it's the greatest game of all time, mark my words. The best. Anyone that says different. We're fighting a war here, ladies and gentlemen. A war against...
It sounds like it could be Bernie Sanders, like the voice itself, just as much as Trump. It's interesting.
If this game doesn't get funded, we'll know.
Because they're both old men.
This game is going to be huge.
Based on the popular secret identity games Mafia, Avalon, and Werewolf, Not My President is a high-energy 3 to 12 player game of deception that lasts 5 to 10 minutes.
I can't give the political ones too much a chance. Hey, later, Chow. Alright, let's see. What do we got next? Your date with an alien. In this visual novel, you get to do what you never thought you would. Fall in love with an alien. Oh, baby, my antennas hurt. A video. Let's see. Is this the next Drimp? I mean, obviously not, but... This is some good music. Fully original soundtrack. I'm gathering that. The visuals are great in this visual novel. Is he gonna talk to me now? What the? Oh, it's okay, never mind. This is about the Kickstarter. They are kind of stuck in a void called Kickstarter. That's why I started an Alien Starter campaign. Give me the good, if you know what I mean. What is happening here? Is he trying to fuck me or play basketball? Alright. Let's see what I get for donating the most money. Oh, I get to make his game. Okay. I love when the top options are, you can make my game. Alright, the dating game. This looks fantastic. Live action video game featuring people going on first dates live. What?
Hey, is this Fran?
Hey, is this Fran?
Hey.
Hi, this is Fran. Who's that?
Hi, Fran. It's Louis. I'm here to guide you through your dates.
Hi, I'm Phoebe.
Hey, I'm Lily.
I'm Sophie.
This is Rich and Emma, your love gurus. I'm here to guide you through your date.
Thank goodness. I am so bad at this.
Don't worry. We'll work it out. We'll be fine.
Fran, you're rocking it. You're rocking it.
Don't worry, Fran. We've got this.
Okay, let's go.
The dating game can be played solo or with a group of friends. You log in at home, connect to your character, and get ready to guide them through a blind date.
What?
Be prepared to give them a confidence boost.
Your hair looks so nice.
You look really great.
And instruct them on exactly how to interact with their date.
Oh, God.
Wait. So, we're connecting to a live person going on a first date. And they have, like, a head cam or, like, a secret camera? Is the other person in on this?
Clean it up, get a napkin, clean it up. Just mop up your date.
Ew. Oh, my God. Oh, Fran, offer a napkin.
Oh, Fran, show you're not impressed.
That is so
outrageous. That is out of order.
Yeah, you can see on his face. You've got this booty in the bag. Yeah, wrap it up.
What?
Get the bill.
The dating game is performed by actors who will respond to whatever you say.
It's actors, but you just have the actors ready at all times? How is this possible? This would be the most expensive game of all time. This is insane.
Every single game will be completely unique. Will you sweet talk, small talk, or just plain dirty talk?
Hi, I'm Dan.
I'm Mel.
I'm Elida. And together we are Blockstop.
Blockstop make live-streamed interactive games by using actors and adapting existing technology.
We've spent the last few years making some really creative and ambitious live-action video games.
Now we want to make a live-action video.
And now give me an example of a game you've made, because I can't see this formula working at all. It makes no sense. So you're just gonna have people waiting at all times? Actors just ready to go on fake first dates?
That absolutely anyone with a decent internet connection can log in and play from anywhere in the world. But to do this, we need more than just our creative wits and our experiences. We also need money.
With £8,000, we can make this game happen. This money will go to several major areas. First of all, the production costs for the live elements of the game. So things like actors' fees and set and props. Secondly, it will go to things like game development.
Will 9.19k last you?
Third, it will go towards the
long enough
fees of running the game. Things like the payment platform fees that we have to pay.
With this amount of money, we can make a game that has four characters to choose from. If we were to raise more money, we could expand our scope, creating more characters, settings, and also more opportunities to play the game.
In a world where people are swiping, clicking, and televising their way to love, we believe that a dating game is a great way to really mix things up and explore just how silly or serious the world of modern dating really can be.
So, if you fancy controlling a date as it plays out, if you fancy playing a live-action video game from the comfort of your own living room, if you fancy backing something crazy and unique and fun and ambitious, then please, support us.
Ambitious indeed. Do you know the budget you'd need to actually do this? and to sustain it? Like, you'd have to have, like, a facility of just people waiting to take your weird demands through an earpiece. Oh, Lord.
Donate.
And spread the word.
Yeah!
Yeah, we have no accurate conception of how things work. Oh, Lord. It would have to cost a fucking shitload to play this game even once.
Wait for sense, quiet meal.
Hey!
Hit the showers.
You, Mill!
Oh, fuck.
Thank you for that 27 months. Oh, shit, look at $1,500 gets you a platonic date with all three Blockstop directors. Includes first base. It's... hopefully people don't take that literally. So you get
First off, hold on. Okay, no one's claimed it. This is I don't know why you would have any interest in meeting these developers. It's like when Shenmue had like this option, I understood. Like, you might want to have dinner with Yu Suzuki. Like, of course, he's a famous guy who made something fantastic. I should claim it though, and I can live stream it, and you guys can tell me what to say on our platonic date. All right, she's a background in playful performance and workshop delivery. Let's admit. Yep. No feasible experience. No actual things are named here. We have a theater woman, like a casting director, and a guy. And there we go. That's exactly what you get. Makes sense. That's what you get with these here arts degrees, my man. You get a lot of unrealistic peoples.
Make your very own RPG like never before. Introducing the best and most powerful RPG maker software ever created. RPG Maker MV.
Wait, that's not this.
Unleash your creativity and
create
worlds from your imagination.
Your video is an RPG Maker advertisement?
Epic story and share it with the world. No programming necessary.
Oh my god! This is next level, dude. You see a lot of RPG Maker games on here, but never has somebody just used the RPG Maker ad as their own Kickstarter video. That's incredible.
With this powerful 2D game engine, employ classic front or side view battle systems in this revolutionary game making tool. Build games for and minds like never been.
Oh my god, it's just programmers. That's incredible. Wow. I love that. That's amazing. Early access spiel. That's the video, man. It's an RPG Maker game. I'm impressed, dude. I mean, normally you see a game, you're like, obviously it's made in RPG Maker, and it kind of diminishes expectations a little bit. You know, there have been some good games with RPG Maker, but, I mean, that's next level. Dark October is a 3D action RPG similar to the Fable series, but in an urban world. Holy shit. Fable in the streets! Fable in the streets! Bam! It's like music you would hear in the movie Blade. Fire, water, air, earth. Avatar. Making magic. This is some satanic shit, my man. Don't set the trap. Oh, don't do it. Ah! No!
Oh my god, no! Fuck. Now listen, I'd be sold if he was 12. And he told me he had ambition? Wait, let's see if he tells me his... Are you 12? That's all I care about. Let me get to the important stuff here. Like whether or not he's 12 years old. Bun Bun. Control F ambition. I should. Well, I'm just trying to get to the risks. Damn, he's got charts and shit. Tax. Fees. Development. I'm gonna have to buy a lot of pizza, my man. Previously, Bun Bun Studios has been contracted to work on projects and deliver them on time, if not earlier. Oof! Bun Bun was early on those contracts? Oof! We have a lot of experience with Unity 3D Engine, as demonstrated on our YouTube. We include a possible recent delivery estimation. Boo, you gotta tell me that there's no risk. That's what I need. I feel like I've seen a few of these. Like, we saw Dendama, you guys remember this? Online, ball in the cup. It hasn't really caught on with the people. Maybe like some Dendama loving 1%er will get in on this.
Kendama enthusiast.
Kendama.
I worked at Sony where I was involved with new project running and that development. But since then, I came to.
I love Dendama!
As a way to connect candle players all around the world. Dendama is a battle ready smart Kendama.
Like battle ready. Alright, it's got all kinds of technology and it's online. That's all you need to know about that project. Who We Are Now, a queer post-apocalyptic visual novel. Fuck yeah, dude. How queer.
To a settlement called home. To find a community, perseverance across and true.
Yes! Walk. A fun, hands-on game that lets kids be creative while also problem-solving and learning the fundamentals of programming. Let me tell you something, dude. Let me just break it off for you. You know every fucking good-ass game you have access to? Most kids have access to that shit, too. Alright? So if you're gonna tell me that you can give a kid a math bracelet or, like, a maze... And he's gonna learn math and have fun. I don't believe it. He's gonna play Call of Duty, and he's gonna call grown men bitches, and he's gonna scream the N-word, and your child's just gonna grow up to be a terrible person. It's the internet these days. I've lost all hope for the younger generation. It's not possible to give a child an educational game, all right? Oh!
Hey buddy. Happy Pi Day. My name is David.
Happy Pi Day? Oh, this was a long time ago.
I'm not the best marketer in the world, but I really wanted to share this idea with you of this game called Walk++. There's a lot of games out there that try to teach kids how to program. What I found was that they're expensive or they require an iPad or a computer. The kid's on a video screen. Maybe he's not actually playing along with his friends. I really wanted to create one that's much more accessible, way more affordable, doesn't require any batteries or anything like that, and that's Walk++. It's a board game where there's characters and there's obstacles, but instead of moving the characters around one step at a time, you actually have to use these action pieces to create a set.
Not buying it. You You tell me childs out there don't have access to batteries? You tell me childs? Are you telling me childs don't have video games? They do. They don't need your game. They have Call of Duty. I think I fucked up. God. Damn it. My audio delay was on 500 milliseconds this whole time, and I didn't even know. Didn't even know. Alright, sorry. Okay, anyways, back to work. $5,000 asking price. This game is a variant of the drinking game, High Low. But it's like an anime guy on here? I'm excited. I'm not excited anymore. I just want to voice that because if you don't realize that your Kickstarter video pierces the eardrums of whoever listens to it, then you're obviously set up for failure just from the jump. Am I supposed to drink to this? It'd be the most fucking depressing night of drinking of all time. I'm funding it. Yeah, I'm all in. How much? $2,000 or more. An artist will create the digital files of a custom deck for you based on a theme. Okay. Hey, Ignacio Cabron! Hey, I got a haircut today. That's why I'm not wearing the beanie. Because you guys didn't know because I wore the beanie so much, but my hair was long as all hell, my man. Alright. You said there was a dating sim? Romantic comedy visual novel. His tuna... Fuck. Fuck! Tell me what it is, daddy-o. Fuck me up. A high school student that suffers from 8th grade syndrome. You know, most people who play games like these suffer from 8th grade syndrome in that they're really into 8th graders. I'm backing it. Oh, and I'm playing the demo. It's not. David F. We've got Bori, Rond, Ayano, and David F. Fantastic. Looking forward to David F. Slash and Shoot. It's currently got 500 sec. 200 sec. Whew. Alright. Mysteries of Cow Island. An old school. Old school. Why do this? Why do this? Why spell this like this? Come on, man. Why K? Come on.
This looks like, what's that game? Oxenfree. But not Oxenfree at all. Look at that creepy ass move to the next screen hand in the fucking disembodied pants. This is an enchanting soundtrack. Come on! Demo has arrived. Don't ask me to play that demo either. None of these even look fun and funny in an entertaining way. Quote crazy. Hitler and Trump edition. That edition. An exciting game of quotes from two of history's leaders. The question is, who said what? Alright.
Quote crazy is an exciting new card game featuring quotes from either Trump or Hitler. Can you tell the difference? Each player starts the game with a Trump and Hitler card.
Okay.
You read the quote, and your friends try to guess who said it. By putting either their Hitler or Trump card in the middle and revealing them at the same time. Let's see some examples. We should just cancel the election.
I'm going to go with Donald Trump.
Who said it?
Nah.
In this case, it was Trump.
I got it. It was Trump.
Let's see some more examples.
I got it. That was me, by the way. I guessed it.
There is never an excuse to hit a woman.
I'm going to go with the Gorons.
In this case, it was Hitler.
There's never an excuse to fuck a woman, said Hitler, because he was gay.
Sometimes,
I read that in a history book.
A new way to win the war. Who said it?
I think it was the Gorons. Hey, Durant! Thank you for that subscription. Many blessings. We should deport the Gorons. I don't think Trump would ever. I have inside information that Trump loves Gorons. He can't get enough. Hey, where are the Gorons?
Hello, it's Aaron Drew.
Fresh out of prison.
Here I'm the creator of the baseball card game known as First Innings Baseball. It's first product from Card Game Creations, a company of my own design and creation. So what we do with Baseball Card Game is we create a team of baseball players from your collectible baseball cards, such as this one here. Obviously that's a pitcher and then there's a batter just here. Lay them out in your team as well. Down here.
That is how you play the baseball card game. Thanks very much.
So hello again people, we're back at the Perth Heat for the following day's play. Look at that.
He took it on the road. This seems like some found footage movie. You know what I mean? This guy is gonna end up murdering in this plot line that I'm making up on the spot. Hey, don't worry, Durant. I gave you a real thank you, a real solid thank you. What chili? What chili? What chili? What chili? Can you beat the heat? The new game, What Chili, by Lisa McCartney. What?
With races of flights and numbugs.
Award-winning and
dude, they made numbugs? Shit, dude. That game is how I met my first wife. Who later died from eating a hot chili.
How many games?
Comes the brand new spicy card game, What Chili.
What?
Six sets of six spicy chili cards.
And a 12-sided dice.
Multiple unique games for you to play.
Hi, I'm Ian, the hot-headed one full of daft ideas, and always racing on to the next thing.
And I'm Lisa, and I'm the cool one.
Stopping me from racing on to the next thing.
Keeping him under control.
And stopping me from racing on to the next
and
thing.
And together,
what's happening?
We are Plight. We make fun, competitive, unique number games.
Wait, Plight?
Today we'd like to give you a flavour of what chili, to find out whether you can beat the heat.
It's the fucking Plight of the common man, indeed.
A fast-paced game that involves bluffing your opponents with plenty of...
Hey!
Sheba!
Hit the showers.
Hey! The shot! Sheamus! Thank you very much for that subscription, I appreciate it.
Was trying to pick chili.
Salsa.
Chili. Scorchio. Heat Seeker. You got it? You fucking got it, you idiots? It's hot chili, my man! If you don't get it, you don't get it. But we need $5 million for this project. And I'm looking forward to it. Bridgewood, the video game, survival horror. The trailer you're about to see is based upon the Total Conversion edition of the titled game. Alright, he's like, this shit is gonna suck, so don't judge us, but give us money. It's an ad for Kickstarter. Oh! In 2015, after a proper noun mother, it's because it was the symbolic mother, like the mother of all men, filed a missing persons report for her proper noun daughter, because, you know, it's the daughter, the big one. She is all her mother. Nothing could prepare them for the events ahead. Server instructions. I just keep expecting for a jump scare. It's just all I'm waiting for. And this dude picks up fucking server instructions. While like Crow won't shut the fuck up in the background. I really pissed off the crows. He shouldn't have turned that on. Oh, wait, is this the mother? Wait, are we in the... We're coming from the perspective of the mother? You guys ever have a really long fucking eyebrow hair? It's just absurdly long. It's just... There's just a lot of mysteries in life. They should make a game about that, not mothers and daughters. This is fucking scaring me, dude. No! That was just a single enemy approaching. It wasn't even a jump scare. I didn't even jump. Wait, is he gonna explain to me? I like the end where it's just like a webcam and the guy's like, hello, I'm John, and you're at my Kickstarter, and this is the Total Conversion Edition. I need $4 million. Oh. You're Bodie Dalton, one of the four elite- SHUT THE FUCK members! Anyways, Mother's gonna hold it down, that's for sure. Tic-tac-toe, the unbeatable. Sorry, what? He's working on a mobile tic-tac-toe game. Oh. You know, tic-tac-toe is... It's unwinnable if you know the strategy, right? It's, you don't need, that just happens. I'm gonna make a game of tic-tac-toe that you can't win. I'm developing it for iOS and Android and for your Google Glass. Starfighter Inc. Battle Room, sci-fi board game, Arabic North African tabletop terrain. Oh yeah, we already did that flight simulator thing. We already did this too, and we didn't do that. Wait. I know this, by the way, it's two. Good. This is the beta test, and don't judge this like it's the final product. It's the beta.
Hey.
It's the beta. Hey, whoa, Andy Dumont. That name just kept going, and it kept getting better. Thank you for that resub. Let's make it go further. I never thought that I could go this far, but hey, it is really here. Let's make it better together. 32 minutes! Does he talk to me this whole time? Oh no, it's like he's got commentary and everything. Ah. Alright, that's the rest of the stream, me watching this fucking guy talk. Oh, he's not even speaking English! Someone translate this for me.
可以點呢?嗱,側邊呢,左邊有三個掣,就可以控制嗰個遊戲嘅...
You're reading what you wrote and it's almost incoherent? That was my college experience, like, by my senior year. And then I get an A on the paper and I'd be like, wait, what? I couldn't understand what I was saying. Alright, another Donald Trump project. It's a voodoo doll. That's weird. That's really weird. If you want this... That'd be a little unstable, my man. For Charlie Voodoo doll? Toss that away, man. I'm heavily affected by black magic. Can I fuck it? I can do that? That's good. What's the best one? The wax original. Dude, I want that. It's like getting Rio's jacket. It's the original. I'm down to attack Trump with magic. That sounds good, but I don't want a voodoo doll. I want to use my Sith lightning. I'm going to use my Sith chain lightning. In endeavors, the horizon of stars. All right, cavern of light bulbs, my boy. A
Any updates on the Shenmue 3 Kickstarter? There was an update, I think, a month ago. And they're working on animations and shit. I don't know. This looks like an actual game. It's something that exists. I'm not gonna poo-poo on it. Meyer, the Eternal Light, steampunk adventure following a young sky pirate named Meyer. Planned launch in 2 to 3 years. Let's... No! I wanna... Oh, man. I would love a guy to explain his steampunk adventure to me. Oh, that's what I really needed. Oh. I love steampunk guys. Damn it. This $500 will get us through 2 to 3 years. To start off, my name is Kevin Mason. A few of my college friends have come together and began the designing and development of a new... Hey, big fat animal thing! Oh, yes! Thank you for that year. I really appreciate it. Thank you for the kind words. Alright. The story of Meyer, who lives in a world with sky pirates and sky rogues. It also contains many sky islands on it. He and his sky pirate crew. Sky was used 8 times in this paragraph. Wait, no, it was used a lot of sky. A lot of sky. Embark on a journey to save the world from a ruthless band of sky rogues in a corrupted city. Meyer, however, has more to him than he thought as he and his team accomplish different missions to save the island of Balingua. Oh man. The island of Balingua! Now, with the possibility of risk, for example, not enough supporters for us to put aside our already busy college lives for. If you give us enough money, we'll drop out of college to work on Meyer's sky adventure. Take me to Balingua, my man. Dude. It doesn't become good if you put sky in front of everything. It does become steampunk, which is it's up to every individual's interpretation whether or not making something steampunk is good or not. Devil's Marking by Sophia Powers, the daughter of Austin Powers. Let's see what's going on. Whoa. Hold on. I'm in this now. Now you use some vulgarity, you got me hooked. So why the fuck would they invite me to the most prestigious school? Move. I looked up. She said, move now, you do it, dog. Whoa. You do it, you dog. Did I ever tell you guys that story of... I was in like a freshman composition class as a senior because I didn't take it. And then I had to go take it, even though I was an English major and I had written like 4,000 papers. And I took this freshman composition class and we had a paper and we were doing like a peer review group, which I fucking hated more than anything. And there was like this Chinese exchange student, like this sweet young girl. And she wrote a paper and... like, my paper was fucking crazy, and I was, like, swearing in it because I didn't give a shit, and I was just being really loose, and she read my paper, and she did revisions on her, And then next time I read her paper, she handed it back to me, and she was fucking cursing so much in her paper because she read mine, and I was cursing in mine. Man, I wish I still had her paper. I corrupted a Chinese woman. And it was just completely, like, it was completely fucking, like, tone deaf. Like, she was just cursing in random places. Oh, man. And I told her, I'm like, it doesn't really fit the tone of the paper. Tell us about the kid who got spooked and got popcorn for her. Told that story a million times, man. But,
hey,
you know, I'm always happy to tell it again. Because it's the best. Bismarck's... Hey! I will find him. Thank you for that 1 year, dude. My funniest memory in life, right? This is this kid... We in middle school, we went to see Master and Commander in theaters for some reason. The Russell Crowe, like, ship movie. And I had a guy in my class named Ralph. Really nice guy. He's a weird guy, though. He was, like, super patriotic. And I remember, actually, with Ralph, he gave a speech, a rousing speech at our middle school graduation, where he yelled into the microphone that he's like, you should be proud to be an American. It's our middle school graduation, so everyone's like, what the fuck is he talking about? Anyways, we went to see Master and Commander, and Ralph bought a big old large thing of popcorn. And 2 minutes into Master and Commander, there's a large cannon shot that comes out of nowhere. And Ralph fucking takes his popcorn. He's like, oh, he's so caught off guard. And the popcorn must have spewed fucking 5 feet in the air, my man. So it's just Ralph's popcorn explosion has kept me laughing for, it must be fucking 25 years. That's not true. It didn't happen when I was 3 years old. I can't do math. Anyways, here we go. Oh, Ralph. Everyone should be goddamn proud to be an American. It's eighth grade, dude. Chill out. I think he joined the Marines. I was catching up with him on Facebook like 5 years ago, and I asked him, I'm like, are you single-handedly defending us from foreign threats? And like as a joke. And he got offended. And he was like, no, I'm not single-handedly defending us. The Marines are helping me. Like, shut the fuck up, dude. Fuck you. Still a good guy, though. Oh, man. See, man, I don't understand. All right, anyway, fuck that game. He's a very serious Marine. There are a million Marines that, like, wouldn't get offended by that statement. Sam Hain world! This was, like, a real game. Dude, that guy shrank quite a bit, my man. They give him weaponized popcorn. Well, what they did is they gave him a popcorn bucket filled with grenades. And when they need to hit a passing ship, passing airplane, they just have them take the pins out and go, huh! Please, Samhain World, ladies and gentlemen. A ball many colors game. I'm in, baby! Pitch me the ball many colors game! I don't know what's going on! What is happening? The Iron Blade Table Tennis Club? Handcrafted black iron table tennis plates? This is the weeb. This is when the worlds of weebs and ping pong players collide. It was forged with the finest steel one can find from the merchants in Edo. And $500,000. Hell yeah! Hell yeah. Alright. Illusion Trails is here again, ladies and gentlemen. For the third time, Illusion Trails is back. Are you guys enjoying seeing this for the third time? Again, I don't understand the sped up walking from this far away.
Hello, I'm Gary Baumhoff. My father, John Baumhoff, and I are some of the developers for Illusion.
It's back again. Alright, I think, Star Fury, I think. Wait. Copyright infringement, baby, but we're close to our goal. World of Potter. The demand for chocolate frog cards has been big. The team behind World of Potter thinks that this is a great idea and would be a fantastic new and exciting dimension to the World of Potter universe. What the fuck is the World of Potter universe? That's not your intellectual property, my man. Let's sue this guy on behalf of J.K. Rowling. Two ships. Oh fuck, I don't want to talk shit about this guy. He's gonna fuck me up. That's why he put this right here. That Winsmore guy fucking says one word. Gonna train for months. He's gonna beat up all the haters, my man. Alright. That's that. Oh Lord. So the best Kickstarter today undoubtedly is the one with the fucking 12-year-old who's scamming everybody. I respect it. I like it. And I wish him the best. And I also wish him the worst. Yeah, I'm excited.
Hey.
Hey, Two Bears Coffee Shop. Oh, shit. Hey. Two Bears. Whoa, you guys remember that? Two Bears. Whatever. Oh, Lord. Hey. I gotta go. I gotta pack my bags because I'm leaving for another country and I haven't done it yet. So, please forgive me. I gotta get out of the country! Alright, no problem, guys. I'm gonna miss streaming. I'll try and make something happen. I'll probably be snapping stuff with my phone. If you wanna follow me on Snapechat. My Snapchat is Charlie Wins. Charlie W-I-N-Z. Hey, don't worry. I won't Homer Simpson myself, my man. Oh Lord. Will I stream in Japanese? I'm gonna try and work something out. And I will stream only in the Japanese language. Tweet some? Yeah, I'll get on my social media shit for this trip. I won't just be tweeting live stream links. I gotta become a real social media boy while I'm gone, so you guys keep in touch with me. Also, very important, don't unsub for me. Do not unsubscribe. Listen. I feed my children with this money. And if you unsubscribe from me, I will find you and kill you. Anyways, I'm gonna miss streaming a lot. I love streaming! Who's gonna watch Luffy? Fiem's mom. Who's got it going on? Cry on stream. Ah! Alright, bye. I'm gonna go. I'll see you guys on... a long time from now. So sad. Man, I feel bad. I know I'm just delaying this, but I feel legitimately bad that I have to go for so long. But hey, man, I'm treating myself. You know? I'll see you guys though. You know, I will return gloriously with some tales of Nihon, and we'll pick it up from there, baby. Here's that song, and farewell. I will keep in touch with you all. Farewell. See you in 2 weeks. Hold on. Let me reset the song. No, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. See, go.